Good afternoon. Thank you for braving the cold and braving this new world, whatever this new reality that we're in, to be here in person. We have a collection of people who are joining us via stream, which I'm thrilled about. Hello to you. Welcome to you as well. So hopefully over the course of the concert, you're going to get a sense of a number of things having to do with the genesis of this concert, but also the genesis of some of the relationships of the people of the Davids. Paula, our cellist, is new to all three of us, but we are so thrilled that she has joined us for this concert and blessed us with her beautiful playing, and it just adds so much. So just by way of introduction, I guess I need to turn on the amplifier. You see the switch, it says mute, just pull it, no, forward. You see the green light? Pull that switch forward. Ah, there we go. So the year was 1984. And I know we were just talking about this. There's a book, 1984. But the year 1984 was a much better year than what was in the book.
Our meeting was not Orwellian.
No, it wasn't. So by a stroke of fate, by fortune, two Davids arrived in New York City to study at cantorial school and became best friends. And much happened as a result of this friendship. In fact, my beautiful wife was somewhat attached to David 1.
I became David 2.
Not soon enough. So, in 1984, we had the fortune as well to meet another soon-to-be cantor. Her name was, and still is, Benji Ellen Schiller. And the first piece today is by Benji Ellen Schiller. And it's all about what we do and what we hope all of you do as well, which is sing your praises to Adonai.
Zamra Elohai Beodi, Ahalila, Ahalila, Zamra Elohai Beodi,
Zamra Elohai Beodi, Zamra Elohai Beodi, Ahalila, Ahalila, Zamra.
We call your name, we sing your praise, oh Holy One, blessing. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
Hallelujah.
Azamra Elohai Behodi.
Azamra Lohai Beodi, I will sing praises to you, O God. And as David said, we got together, the three Davids and Paula, and it was through friendship and what kind of program shall we put together? And we thought about our names. And so once you're thinking about David, you're thinking about, of course, Beloved, so that opens up all these love songs. And then we thought about David Melech, and it opens up all of Psalms. So you're gonna hear some beautiful Psalms this afternoon, some love songs, and hopefully just some wonderful warmth of the friendship that that we all share. So here's a melody from Shir HaShirim, from the Song of Songs, and it's a setting of chapter 6, 3, and verse 2, 10 to 13. I am my beloved is mine.
I am my beloved's. My beloved is mine. Rise up, my fair one, and come away, for lo, the winter passes and the rain is gone. The voice of the turtle dove is heard in the land. The time of singing has come. For lo, the winter has passed, my love. The rain
Cantor Lawrence Avery was a mentor to so many cantors over the course of many years. He taught at Hebrew Union College. David and I were blessed to have him as one of our teachers, one of our mentors, one of our coaches. He was just an astonishingly wonderful cantor, and he sang like an angel. I studied at Juilliard, and just had the most beautiful lyric tenor voice, and he would be what some would consider a German-style cantor, in that he, when he sang cantorial music, it was much like art song, as opposed to more of the Eastern European style, which is a little different. A lot of times when you hear about a cantor, you hear the Eastern European style, not so much with Cantor Avery. But what a joy and a pleasure and an honor that it was for us to study with him. And this song, Kishoshana, was composed by Cantor Avery, by Lawrence Avery, for his daughter's wedding. And it was dedicated to her, and it was something that I had the fortune to join with him on a number of concerts, and he sang this numerous times, and we sang together. So, Kisho Shana, texts from Song of Songs, the poetry of demonstrating love of God for the people Israel through the imagery of love between man and woman.
This is a little expansion of how you might envision Shalom Rav. It's by Jonathan Commissar, who lives in New York. And my wife always says she hears a little Broadway in his music. But may great peace descend upon us and all Israel and all the world. So the message is a little bit different than the Jeffrey Klepper that I do most Friday nights. But I think you'll enjoy this setting very much. Shalom Rav.
Israel, Amka, Tasi.
I will give thanks, another setting from Psalms. King David was the great writer of the Psalms, and we have many opportunities to praise God, and we're told in Psalm 150 that just by virtue of being able to breathe, we should take that breath, that gift, and turn it over to God, return it to God, sending our voice out in praise. And so this setting from Psalm 9 gives us a sense of that, how our job is to praise, to give thanks, and to recognize the miracles around us, similar to the modim that we pray daily in our liturgy. So I will give thanks by Gershon Kingsley. You might have noticed it recently in the memoriam section of, I think it was the Oscars or the Emmys, that Gershon Kingsley also did composing for theater, for movies, and he passed away in 2019. But he was the music director for many years in, I think it was Dallas, wasn't it? Sure. I think it was Dallas or Houston. It was in Texas somewhere. It's a big state, but he was down there. So I will give thanks.
I would give thanks unto the Lord with my whole heart. Glad glad and exult in thee. I will be glad and exult in thee. I will be glad and exult in thee. I will sing praise to thy name, O Most High. I will sing praise to thy name, O Most High. I will sing praise to thy name, O Most High.
So the next piece we're doing comes from Mishnah Peah, chapter 1, verse 1, actually. And it also is found in the morning liturgy. And we added this piece to the program primarily because the things that we're supposed to do, the obligations that are listed for which there is no limit, and there's no limit to the reward in the world to come either. These things are all displays. They're displays of our love of God that is awakened through the study of Torah. And so it is that thematic thread of love that we felt was important to add here. I'm going to ask David to just give a little introduction to how it is that we went from two to three Davids.
Wow.
Wow.
Two to three.
Yes. I recall a meeting at your congregation.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I recall that.
Oh, boy. Well, this Schane, this David Schane, was came out with his family, Monica, who's Swiss-German, and who's a wonderful flautist. I like to say flutist, but flautist. And his three girls. And in fact, your last girl was born, and all of us were in the hospital room, and I turned my back for 1 second, and his eldest, Katya, who was probably 5 years old at the time, had handed this day-old baby, Talia, to my daughter, who was about seven at the time. And I was like freaking out. What's going to happen? But we met through our executive director at Road of Shalom in California. There was a meeting, and I had been away. And Michael Kamler says to me, I've met this concert pianist. And my first thought was, yes, and I'm Luciano Pavarotti. It would be very nice to meet him. But it turned out he actually was a concert pianist who had been on the stage since he's like 6 years old. In fact, born here in Chicago, what neighborhood was it?
Bud Longwoods and Rogers Park.
So we met. And I've had the joy and pleasure of being his daughter's teacher for their bat mitzvah. And David and I have done a few programs. And so now to bring the three Davids together has been just a tremendous treat, because both David Schane and your beloved Cantor Goldstein, are very big hearts, but also very big musical minds. And they think very deeply about the music, and they bring such a joy through this thought and passion and talent that to sing with them is to really make music at its most deepest level. So it's been such a pleasure. And thank you, David, for having us come here.
So David Margules, Cantor Margules, introduced me to David Schane, and we actually met, and he came here because he comes back and forth to Chicago periodically, and we were talking about doing a concert. It was about 8 or 9 years ago, I think, and he was walking around the temple, and we sort of scouted out the pianos that were on the site, and he sat down at this piano, which he sat down, and a lot of pianists come to this piano and go, can you give me another piano to play on? He sat down on this piano, and he started playing the Ondine from Ravel's Gaspard de la Nuit, and I was floored. First of all, to play at the drop of the hat, the Ondine, that's quite an accomplishment. But he made the piano do things that I'd never heard it do. And no one else was able to do either. They're always talking about how they're fighting this this particular instrument. So we tried to come up with a way to have a concert, and then it fell through. We lost the violinist, and a bunch of things happened. So this was a great opportunity for me, because we've been in touch since then, over, you know, on and off, and then particularly in the last year. So it was a great opportunity for us. To really get to work together. And so these things about relationships and friends and things like that are so critically important, and for us it's sort of a real important part of how we operate together, and the tongue-in-cheek and some of the kidding around we do. But this next piece, Agony, has nothing to do with that. And... But what it does have to do with is how sometimes we have our eyes set on something that is not attainable. Perhaps a woman that's not quite attainable. And no matter how good we are, no matter how princely, how princely we are, right? Just how gorgeous, or how well mannered, or situated in the various kingdoms that we might come from.
And he is Cinderella's prince, and I am Rapunzel's prince.
Yes, yes. So it just a moment of, you know, you just have to suspend your disbelief for just a moment while we sing this. I had the opportunity to sing this past summer for the first time, and fell in love with it. I know the show. It's a great show. If you haven't seen Into the Woods, it's a very clever idea that Sondheim had. But it occurs to me, particularly for David and I, that while we both attained, you know, we both struggled and wanted to find the princess and get the princess, I did, and you didn't. So this is to my princess.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her head. Becoming and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, 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 ah. Agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors.
Agony, all the torture they teach.
What's as intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, an heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there, and you're nearing her, all the while hearing her. Ah, 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 ah.
Agony, misery,
although it's different for each.
Always 10 steps behind.
He's 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach.
Agony, that can cut like a knife. I must have her to
to one.
So as we get the piano ready, just a few words about the Schumann fantasy. While this piece was, dedicated to Franz Liszt, and Liszt was really captured by this piece and promised Schumann that he would put it in his repertoire, and that was saying something because Liszt was quite a talent, and he liked to play his own pieces. They were big, they were very complex, known for one of the most difficult pieces, the B minor, yes, the B minor sonata, and Liszt added this piece to his repertoire. But more importantly for this program, this piece was really written for Clara. Now, Schumann's father, and this is another thread in the program, Schumann's father was not particularly, and Clara's father, excuse me, was not particularly fond of Robert Schumann, and kept the two of them apart. And it caused quite a bit of pain between them. And so Schumann, when he wrote this, he said to Clara, the first movement may well be the most passionate I have ever composed, a deep lament for you. And at the bottom of the published piece is a poem, or a verse. I'll spare you my German, in English. Resounding through all the notes in the earth's colorful dream, there sounds a faint, long, drawn note for the one who listens in secret. Now, David would want me to say that he likes to see this as a part of a connection to Shabbat. David would also want me to say all sorts of things about how he brings out so many different things in the music, but I'm going to say to David that we don't need to hear you talk about it. We want to hear you play it because the music says it all, every last bit. Here is the first movement of Schumann's Fantasy in C.
Thank you.
tender glow of spring. 'Twas in the greenwood's leafy shade. The buds broke forth, the brooklet gushed. We heard the village bell beyond. With youthful bliss our hearts were won, and lost in lover's joy profound. And lovelier still than in my dream was what befell me and the maid. In all the tender glow of spring, within the greenwood's leafy shade, the brooklet gushed, the buds broke forth, the village bell rang out afar. I held thee fast, I held thee long, and I will lose thee nevermore.
So di Provenza, il mar, comes from La Traviata, and much like the story of Clara Schumann and her father, we see how disastrous it is when a father gets in the way of what their child wants to do. As parents, sometimes it takes a lot for us to learn these lessons, but I think that for those of us that have had children and suffered through their difficulties and tried to help them avoid these mistakes, we would have been much better off letting them make their mistakes. And this is the case with this story, and the ending is tragic, like many operas. But this is the scene where Alfredo just found out that Violetta is not going to is going to sort of push him away. This was sort of orchestrated by the father, who then comes to Alfredo and says, you know, don't you remember what it was like? Don't you want to come back home? Don't you want to do all those things? I'm suffering. Do it for me. But as you'll follow along in the translation, you'll get the sense. But the other thing is that I want to just mention here is that I never noticed it before, but as I was preparing for this, I noticed that Germain was a religious man. And twice in the aria, he references God. The first time seeking God's help, and the second time that it's an if-then sort of thing, where if my son comes back and recognizes these things, then I will know that what? Shema Koleinu, that God has heard my voice, that God hears me. So just a little sort of tidbit.
avens aem avius vol, quid al corti cancello, quid al corti cancello, dit provens aem avius vol, al natio fulgende sol, qual destino ti furo, qual destino ti furo, al natio fulgente sol, pur lamentabul nel vol, tibi gioia te brilo, e che pace cola sol, su te splendere ancor può, e che pace cola sol, su te splendere ancor può. Dio mi guidò, Dio mi guidò, Dio mi guidò. Vecchio genitor, tu non sai quanto soffrì, tu non sai quanto soffrì, il tuo vecchio genitor, te lontano di squalor, il suo tetto si coprì, il suo tetto si coprì, di squalor, ma se ti trova il cuore, se mi speme non vali, se la voce dell'onore in te a pieno nanuti, ma se alle fin ti trova il cuore, se mi speme non vali, Dio ne esaudì, Dio ne esaudì, Dio me esaudì, Dio me esaudì, ma se al fin ti trovo ancor, ti trovo ancor, Dio me esaudì. Dio me esaudì.
You might remember that 99-cent movie in Atlanta, and for the folks at home, so you can hear me, Laurie, you might remember that 99-cent theater in Atlanta. Paul reminded us at the last concert that there was a moment with this next song where we were waiting in line and the movie wasn't starting. There was actually sort of a stage in front of the screen, and I'd forgotten this story, but Paul says, I got up there and sang Mattinata, and then everyone had these penny change, and they were throwing their pennies. So don't throw your pennies. But Mattinata, it's a song, Wake with the Dawn, Darling, I am singing my love song to you.
L'aurora di bianco vestita, già l'uscio di schiuri al gran sol, di grigia con le rose spedita, carezza di fiori lo stuol, con musolo infremito al cano, intorno il creato già par, e tu non ti vestire in vano, mi sto qui dolenti a cantare. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e schiudi l'uscio al tuo cantor, ove non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei nasce l'amor. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e schiudi l'uscio al tuo cantor, ove non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei, ove tu sei, nasce l'amor.
So you might, if you know this duet, you might wonder, well, how did this duet make it into this program? And so really, the way I see this duet is all about the power of friendship. It's about the depth of brotherly love, as it were. And so just a brief sort of getting you up to speed on what's happened thus far. What's happened is, both Nadir and Zurga have fallen in love with this priestess, and this priestess was a vision. I mean, she was just amazing, and we both have fallen in love, but we've decided that despite the power of our attraction. Because I'm not sure if it was love or lust, but it was something. But besides that, we decided that we would remain connected to each other and swear off any connection to this high priestess. And the power of our friendship would sustain us. Well, if you know the opera, it didn't quite turn out that way. And Zurga, who really, he was true to his word. He protected Nadir all the way to the end, so much so that Nadir and the priestess got basically escaped, and Zurga died, and by his own fire, as a matter of fact. So, despite the ending, despite the tragedy, the thing that for us was so compelling was this vow of friendship, and in truth, David and I have been friends since 1984, and I would say. Our friendship has sustained each of us, and we remain close and I would say committed to each other in that way, and would do just about anything for each other. So and that remains to this day and into the future, despite the priestess. Despite the priestess. So here is the Pearl Fishers duet.
In case my mom is still awake in New York, actually it's a little later in New York, if she's watching, we sat down, she's now 97, okay, bless her heart. So we sat down some years ago with final plans, and she said, I want David to sing at my funeral. And mom, not too soon, but our friendship is one that really transcends our generations to our children, to our spouses, to our parents, so it's a blessing.
Oh,
rêve, oh, vision, rêve, la foule est à genoux.
Oui, c'est elle, c'est la déesse du chaman et du belle. Oui, c'est elle, c'est la déesse qui descend parmi nous.
Son visage,
mon regard, hélas, la cherche en vain.
Elle fuit,
elle fuit. Ta main me pousse ma main.
Ta main me pousse ma main.
De nos corps l'amour sont parés. On nous change d'ennemi.
Non. Que rien ne nous sépare.
Non, rien.
Que rien ne nous sépare.
Non, rien.
Si l'on veut rester amis.
Si l'on
veut rester amis.
Thank you so much. I invite Susan Longo up to continue with our program.
Thank you.
Hmm? Oh, I'm so sorry.
Hello, welcome. I'm Susan Longo. I'm a member of the executive board here at NSCI and the Imagine the Possible Executive Committee. Thank you. This must begin with our clergy team at NSCI, led by Rabbi Wendy Geffen, and to our staff, led by Executive Director Todd Brayman. Thank you to Cantor Goldstein, a member of our clergy team, who is in charge of all things musical at NSCI. Special thanks to you, all of you in attendance. After 20 months of this pandemic, musicians relish the opportunity to perform before a live audience. There is absolutely no substitute for the interaction and energy that fills a concert hall space. So again, thank you for your support for this event. And thank you too to this evening's musicians, David Schane, our pianist, Paula Kosower, our cellist. Cantor David Margules. And our own David Goldstein. We are so blessed at NSCI for him being our cantor. We at NSCI recently celebrated our 100th anniversary as a congregation. 100 years of service to our members and to the North Shore community. 100 years of worship, education, and the work of social justice. And as a faith community, we look forward to the next 100 years. Your host today, the Imagine the Possible campaign, is how we at NSCI are envisioning those next 100 years. To that end, we have embarked on a campaign to plan the best future for NSCI, to provide a safe spiritual home, and to prepare for growth and change, which may not always be predictable. And we need a modern, flexible synagogue campus truly equipped for the 21st century. Imagine the Possible will enable NSCI to utilize exterior and interior spaces of our campus in all the new ways we interact with one another. We will create new flexible spaces in Frank Hall and Rebecca K. Crown, where we are right now, enhance our abilities to use our beautiful property with new outdoor gathering spaces, ensure the safety of everyone who enters our building, increase the efficiency of workspaces, and improve our technology platform and our digital presence. Over the next several months, you will receive information on the architectural changes to our building and the plans for this campaign. Watch for those developments, actively participate in the campaign, and be excited about the next 100 years at NSCI. And now, Marilyn Perlman, our immediate past president of this congregation and the Imagine the Possible campaign chair, would like to add her words of welcome.
Thank you, Susan, and hello, everybody, and thank you so much for your commitment to our congregation. We're really excited about achieving the goals of our campaign, and I'm delighted to tell you we've raised $10 million, beyond $10 million actually, towards our $12.5 million goal. And we currently have a fantastic opportunity to double the impact of all new and increased gifts of any amount. Due to the extraordinary generosity of a group of donors, donations and pledges received will be matched one-to-one until we reach $500,000. I'd like to acknowledge those who have built this match, and they are Julie and Jeff Echt, Lisa and Eddie Eisenberg, Sherry and Jim Field, Melissa and Swan Nguyen, Harriet and Ted Perlman, Barbara and Victor Weisskopf, and an anonymous donor. We really appreciate your attention. We hope you'd like to learn more about the Imagine the Possible campaign, and we do have information available for you after the concert if you choose to pick it up. And now let's enjoy the encore. Thank you.
Thank you so much to Marilyn and Susan. What an amazing project that has been taking place over these past 20 months, and we are very close, and it's very exciting. For me, just on a personal note, it would be very exciting to have all the clergy in the same space so that we'll see each other, like, every day. That would be really amazing. So, just a little note about this piece, and, should I?
Prankster.
Yes. So, Falca is the king of pranksters, so he thinks. And he has it all set up so that he is going to really play a dirty one on his friend Eisenstein. For those that know the opera know that Falca fails miserably. I don't know why the baritone always gets to fail. but the baritone really fails. But part of the reason for doing this piece has to do with a story that goes back to around 1984-85. David and I, we used to go to the Coles gym at NYU and play racquetball. And we really loved to play sports and games, and we did that as long as we were near each other. We would find ways, whether it was on an outdoor racquetball court around 23rd Street, we would find a way to do it. So, but in Cole's Gym, they had the best showers. You don't know where I'm going with this, but at any rate. For those that love to sing in the shower, you might know that singing in the shower is quite fun because everything just comes right back to you and then keeps bouncing around, and it just sounds so good. Doesn't it? Pavel, you're there. Doesn't it sound really good in the shower? Always sounds great in the shower. So, and David was used to being very spontaneous. And Laurie will confirm this. The scene that he presented about singing Mattinata in the movie theater was not a unique event. This could happen anywhere. It could happen on top of a restaurant table. It could happen on a street corner. It could happen just about anywhere David is, if you cue him with a word or a phrase, he might break out into song. So it was not an accident then that in the shower, we occasionally would break out into duets, quite vociferously, and I feel badly about it now, that anyone had to endure that, but people didn't. We never had anyone throw anything at us. We never had anybody complain. But we would sing in the Coles Gym shower, and this duet was one of the ones that we did. So this is in honor of Coles Gym and the shower.
You were a very good teacher with racquetball, too. He was very patient with me. I was used to tennis, and racquetball's quite different.
Well. So I think what he really wanted me to say was his ability to play racquetball was much greater than my ability to play tennis. He tried to get me to play tennis once, and we were playing doubles, and which is sort of silly since I didn't know how to play tennis. And David was my partner.
I found that out the hard way.
Yes, you did. And one thing I could do really well was hit the ball very hard. And I found out that when you're in tennis and you're playing doubles, apparently the server stands back here and the partner stands here, and the server is supposed to serve sort of in front of the partner into that segment of the court. Is that accurate?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I step back and I toss the ball up, and I hit that thing so hard. I mean, it was hard. But it didn't make it to the other side of the court. But it did land. It was like a perfect shot in the middle of your back, I think. Yeah. It knocked the wind out of him. And he decided that playing tennis with me was maybe not the best choice of activity. So we never played again. Never. But we played a lot of racquetball. So, but this is in honor of our times together and some of the pranks that we might have played and. I might have been successful at least once. I don't know.
Come along to the ball. It will raise your morale. Jail can wait, why should you worry? There's no need for such a hurry. You have time for one more spree. Come and have some fun with me. You will meet the whole ballet, all the pretty ballerinas, mademoiselles and signorinas. They're so lovely and petite. My dear fellow,
What a treat, what a treat. With blondes and brunettes, we will dance and dine and shower confetti and revel in wine. In fun and flirtation, the hours will fly. It's one invitation you can't pass by. Admit that a party like this can fail to put you in shape for your term in jail. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Do you agree?
Yes, I agree. But Rosalinda must never know.
Kiss her goodnight and off we go. Say fare you well, my pretty kitten.
No, no, my lambkin, I shall say, my sweetest lambkin.
Sweetest lambkin, while she's sleeping
peacefully,
you will be the wolf. And under the cover of dark, instead of to jail you embark, with me on a heavenly lark, with me on a heavenly lark. I'll present you as a distinguished foreigner. Your name will be Marquis Renard. No one will be one bit the wiser. Say yes.
Well, I might be persuaded.
You must.
But if...
Now don't be a coward. You owe it to yourself, oh boy.
You are right. You are right. You're absolutely right.
You really will have a delightful time.
Since I'm doing time for another crime, I might as well add one more to the list.
You come then.
How can I resist? Yes, I'll go with you.
This chance is really too good to be true.
To a supper fit for kings, we shall go with hearts delighted. Lovely women are invited. Everybody laughs and sings.
To a supper fit for kings, we shall go with hearts delighted.
Lovely women are invited. Everybody laughs and sings.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful, wonderful night. Drive safely.